For the earth shall be filled with happiness as the waters cover the sea. Isaiah 11:6-9. Folks, I want to talk to you today about happiness being a wave, like a wave. I want to talk to you about happiness being like an electric current. You start out with an electric charge. That's a Q, small Q. And a current is a flow of electric charges. Well, let's make the electric charge a thought. And let's make the current a current of happiness. A current is a flow of electric charge, and it's measured in amperes. And you and I have thoughts, and we send out currents of happiness. Isn't that a nifty analogy? Electric current. The time regular flow of charged particles. And the unit of electric current is the ampere. An electric field, we can translate that to a happiness field. Electric field, the region of space around a charged object. Let's make believe that you and I are the charged object. And there's an electric field around us. A happiness field. We are a charged object in that we are filled with happiness. And why wouldn't we be? This is Lent. And this is the holy season. Thank you, how great thou art. And when you study physics, you really see how great thou art. And that's why I like physics, because it tells me how God does things quantitatively. And we're finding out more and more. Austin and I, when we go to the laundromat, we put the clothes in to wash. Then we sit down and we do quantitative physics problems. New York State Regents examinations. We're up to the one that was given in 2004. And we were doing mechanics and we were getting one right after another. We got about six mechanics quantitative physics problems correct. Then we got into electricity, and the two of us need to study electricity more. It isn't our fault, it's just that we haven't got up to it yet. He hasn't got up to it in high school, and I haven't got up to it yet. And so when we started electricity, we went up to problem 22, and we missed about three. So how many do we get right? Oh, I'd say we got 12 right, 3 wrong. electric field intensity, the ratio that an electric force exerts on a charge, our happiness intensity is the ratio of our electric field. Remember what our happiness field is? To the charge. And we're the charged body, the Q. Let's see what else we got. Magnitude of the charge.
Electric motor.
That would be the magnitude of the charge of happiness that we are radiating. Hey! Electric motor, a device that converts electric energy into mechanical energy. And boy, do you use that all day long, don't you folks? Woo! Wow! Thousands of uses of that. All right, a happiness motor. We convert happiness energy into mechanical energy, for instance, motion. So we do that. Hey, this is, now we know what spreading happiness is. Spreading happiness is that we get all charged up with happiness, right, through our communion with God. And this is Lent, and this is the season. This is the holy season, when we're really charged up. And we have the happiness, and the Holy Grail, and the oneness with God that we've been seeking for maybe 62 years. And here it is in Lent, 2012. So what's an electric motor? A happiness motor is a device that changes happiness, electricity, into motion. Into mechanical energy. Electric potential. Okay, the total work done. Electric potential. The total work done.
By an electric field.
And bringing one coulomb. That's what a charge is a coulomb.
A positive charge.
A positive charge.
Infinity to a specific point.
Hey, infinity. Hey! That smacks of God, doesn't it? Let's go back to that. It all translates very easily to happiness. Listen. Electric motor. Now we're coming up to the one we were working on. Electric potential. Happiness potential. The total work done. Now our work is happiness. You and I have made that contract. We have made the contract that our work in life, our purpose in life, our raison d'etre, our reason for being is happiness.
Electric. this is queuing up. I'm trying to get the other one.
Electric potential.
Electric potential.
The total work done.
Happiness potential. The total happiness done. By an electric field. That's the happiness field that you and I radiate, right? To bring one coulomb of electric charge, one coulomb of happiness charge,
a positive charge,
from infinity, from God, where we get it, to a specific point, and that specific point is what? A person, a cat, a dog, a cow, a pig. Let's hear the whole thing over. Electric potential.
The total work done.
The total work done.
By an electric field.
One coulomb. One coulomb of positive charge from infinity to a specific point. Hey, that one fits beautifully. Hey, that's great. With our communion, with our contemplation, with our solitude, with our meditation, we come from infinity. And then we do the work, which is happiness. And the work is moving a charge of happiness, one coulomb, a charge of happiness from infinity to a specific point, which could be a kitty cat or an ant or a plant. And we bring one coulomb of happiness to that specific point. Whee! Oh, where is this all coming from? This is the glossary in Barron's. Want me to show it to you? You stay right here. It's over here in this drawer. This is Barron's. Regents exams and answers. And the examinations start on the year 2003 and go up through the year 2010. And it gives you the problems, the quantitative problems, and then we have to get good at coming up with the answer to those problems. So the next term defined in the glossary of Barron's. Electric potential is measured in volts. And it's sometimes called voltage. Electric potential, potential difference, electric potential, voltage, measured in volts. Positive, repel, negative, attract. We're turning. Page 30. With God we go,
29.
Who spreads the joy of love. We win each day the happiness of life. We count our blessings. We give thanks, we give joy. Stop, stop the cruel. Stop, 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 stop the cruel. Thank you, Ralph Vaughan Williams. Waiting for the next definition.
Everybody recording?
You recording? You recording? You recording? You recording? Yep. You recording? Electromagnetic induction. A device that uses a magnetic field and mechanical energy I think to do electrical work. Let's listen to it.
A magnetic field. Mechanical energy
used to generate a potential difference. Yeah. An electromotive force. And we will use this constantly. No, electromagnetic induction, a device that uses a magnetic field. Around every magnet, there's a magnetic field. And mechanical energy to generate a potential difference. What's a potential difference? Voltage. So, let's make believe you and I are a magnetic field and we have mechanical energy, that means energy to move, kinetic energy, and together, the mechanical energy and the magnetic field, they generate a potential difference. And a potential difference is voltage, and that's generate a volt. A volt of what? I heard you. Happiness. Yay! It really fits in, doesn't it? I'm sorry that the audio is so low on this. Sometimes it's the magnetic field. Sometimes it's good and clear, and sometimes it isn't. Next glossary. Electromagnetic radiation. That's easy. happiness radiation, the propagation of happiness waves in space. We are sending out happiness waves, just like electromagnetic waves. I've said a long time ago that happiness is like a wave. Happiness is like an electromagnetic wave. Electromagnetic radiation is the sending out propagation in space of electromagnetic waves. Happiness radiation is the propagation in space of happiness waves. I send you happiness, waves of happiness. Okay, I guess we better use the last few minutes for jokes. People want the jokes. Okay. Marilyn calls her son-in-law Blister. Why? He doesn't show up until after the work is done. And the policeman said to the little boy, "Are you related to the people next door?" And the little boy said, "Yes. Their dog's brother is our dog." And at the retirement party, the chairman of the company said, "Harry has always given us an honest day's work, even if it took him 2 years to do it." Marilyn says, "I don't feel myself today." And Carolyn says, "I notice the improvement." The couple had twins. And Uncle Guido was given the honor of naming the twins, a boy and a girl. And he named the girl Denise, and he named the boy DeNephew. A man wanted to join Paranoids Anonymous, but they wouldn't tell him where they held the meetings. Betty was asked, "You always take your paycheck to the bank. You get your paycheck and then you take it to the bank. Why do you do that?" Betty said, "It's too little to go by itself." A teacher says, "For every student who has a spark of genius, there's 10 others who have ignition problems." And the teacher said, "In the old days, the kids used to bring you apples. Now they just drive you bananas." And behind every successful man is what? A proud wife and a flabbergasted mother-in-law. The father said to his son, "Son, with your," talking about his attendance record in school, he says, "With your attendance record, you will never make President of the United States. However, you might make Congress." And Dorothy is so dumb, she thinks that Gatorade is welfare for alligators, crocodiles. Charlie says, "I can't afford to fly to Rome. I can't afford to fly to Paris, to Rome, and to Hong Kong. But my luggage has been to all three." Fullness. new father in the maternity ward said to the man next to him, "Here, have a cigar." And the man next to him says, "Oh, congratulations, is it a boy or girl?" And the new father said nervously, "I don't know one cigar from another." See morning glories. So from this electric field, this force in this electric field, full of the Coulombs that I got from communion with Infinity God, I send you pulses of happiness, joy, success, peace, greatness, power, purity, perfection. Thanks. Elucidation. Enlightenment. Illumination. Ecstasy. Exhilaration, effulgence, oneness with God, union with the divine, union with the absolute. Spiritual reality. Amen. This is Lent. Buddy, how are you today? Happy? You and I made a contract with each other that we would make each other happy. And we have to start with jokes because Matt Sullivan says there aren't enough jokes on a chat with Glendora. So, the boss says to the employee, do you like to meet new people? Yes. Well, do you like a change? Yes. Well, would you like a new job? Yes. Well, you just follow up one more time. The girl was put in charge of doing advertising for the bowling alley and to make it attractive to teenagers and parents. And this is what she came up with. Get your kids off the streets and into the alleys. You know the great advantage of bowling over golf? In bowling, you never lose the ball. And now, who was the last man to box Joe Louis? The Undertaker. Ed says the mind is a wonderful thing, and his wife says, yes, dear, everybody should have one.